Cowboys ain't easy to love, and they're harder to hold. They'd rather give you some than diamonds or gold.
Lone Star belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. If you don't understand him, and he don't die young, he'll probably just ride away.
Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up.
For over 20 years, MTN Business has been Africa's premium portal for business connectivity solutions, offering world-class solutions for SME, enterprise and public sector businesses. Whether it's through connectivity, communication, collaboration or cloud solutions, MTN Business recognizes an opportunity to help large and small businesses to set off on a sustainable growth path. It also helps governments make positive impact on people's lives.
We have invested in what I call the Microsoft Azure Park. What that does, it is a data center service that helps a customer not to invest in capex. So they don't need to invest in capital expenditure. We are saying we'll give you the data center service out of MTN. All you need to do is bring your applications, run them from our platforms, and happy to go. That saves you from buying the servers that you need to put in there. That saves you from having upgrades of the software that you are using. That saves you from having the resources to monitor, to upgrade, to refresh that equipment. MTN will take care of that. We shall give you the platform to do what you need to do. It's like giving you a key to your house. What you do in that house is really not a big deal for us. We've also gone a step further and said, we cannot win on our own in this market. It's super critical that we get partnerships. And we've partnered with the likes of Microsoft. The Azure platform is a Microsoft product. But we've gone and said, we also have people that want to have their data stored here in country. Hence, we give you this Azure platform. But on top of that, we are saying, what do you need to do if you want to run your Office 365 and you want to buy it locally from a trusted partner? We've moved on with Microsoft and we can sell you this Office 365 today, meaning your Outlook email, your Excel, your Word, your PowerPoint, you can buy today from MTN. We also provide what I call IPBX telephony. Traditional way of buying telephone is you have a PBX with a reception on this big keyboard trying to control what is happening. And we are saying, forget about that. We'll give you a cloud platform for IPBX. And what it does, it not only does it give you a fixed line, which is our voice over IP, not only does it give you a fixed line, but this is actually a phone that you are able to travel with.
Since its inception in 1994 in South Africa, the telecommunications giant has continued to grow, spreading its roots into 24 countries in Africa and Middle East.
MTN operates in 24 countries, so we are present in 24 countries where we have got physical presence, but in each country there will be different branches that could be operating here. For instance, here in Kenya, we do have an office in Nairobi, we have an office in Mombasa, and we have an office in Kisumu. In the 24 markets in which we operate, 5 of those are actually in the Middle East, and 19 of them are actually in Africa. So we are the biggest mobile operator probably on the continent. So MTN as a company was actually launched in 1994 as a South African company just after South Africa got independence. And we have expanded in the 24 operations. Out of those 24 operations, two of them do not have GSM. The rest of them actually do have GSM. The two operations that do not have GSM is Kenya and Namibia. But the rest of the operations in which we are, our business is actually broken into two, where you have the enterprise business unit and the consumer business unit, which is much more on the mobile side. If you go back to MTN enterprise business, which is predominantly where we operate as MTN Kenya, I just want to spend a bit of time on that. Why do we have enterprise business as part of the arm of MTN? I think you'd agree with me where we sit today, across the world, how the mobile business is actually struggling. Voice is not one of those businesses you pride yourself to be running in this time, compared to how it was in the early 2000s when mobile phones were just coming into play, especially in Africa. We may brag and say we do have 240 plus subscribers across our footprint, but can we show the money for it? And the reality be told, it is not a cash cow for us anymore. It's a good to have, but you and I know that today you can have your WhatsApp, you've got your Skypes, where you do not need a SIM to make a phone call. You don't actually need a handset to make a phone call. Hence the reason MTN decided we need to diversify in our business, and hence the birth of enterprise. The enterprise organization actually started from the time when we bought the UUNET organization, which was in Kenya, in Zambia, in Namibia, and in Botswana, which was doing pure enterprise. And that concept now has been replicated across our footprint where we operate. We do have the enterprise organizations in most of the countries that we operate today. And why do we need to have this? The reason we want to have this is we have realized that our customers today are not only wanting to be connected via mobile, but there's bigger connectivity that they need to have. For instance, their internet, when you are talking of a bigger organization, how do they get their internet connectivity? You've got organizations that are playing across different branches, across geographies. How do we take care of these customers in a bigger way beyond mobile? Hence the reason why we have enterprise, because then we can offer these customers what we call global MPLS or local MPLS, which is a connectivity which gives a customer a seamless connectivity across the same network seamlessly. So they can talk to each other on the same network, same kind of latencies that they'll be getting. That's one of them. The other reason is MTN is a very big organization. It's a global company. If you are present in 24 countries, it means you are a true Pan-African organization. And with that Pan-African organization, we do recognize that most of our customers have got entities across the footprint. And who's best set up to serve them? I think MTN is in that such a good space to be able to serve them. Across our footprint, we've got like 24, we've got about 47, 48 data centers today, including the new one that we have now in Nairobi, which we just launched in March, which is a tier 3 data center. And what this hub does is it allows us as MTN to be able to serve these customers, give them the geo redundancy that they need across our footprint. So if I've got a customer here in Nairobi that needs to be served in Rwanda, in Uganda, in South Sudan, that allows me to be able to serve them.
Its evolution from a mobile company into a multifaceted entity offering services in connectivity and other modern business needs is a clear indication of its stellar growth. The multinational company boasts of a total of 240 million subscribers and is still targeting other unreached markets.
We have got close to 240 million subscribers across our footprint. Traditionally, I think people used to know us as an ISP, which is your internet service provider, and I'm saying we are no longer that because we are not an internet service provider. We are an enterprise solution provider. Yes, traditionally we've provided internet. An extension of that is the global MPLS, which I mentioned, including the local MPLS. But then One thing that we do realize with those, that kind of our products is everyone is offering internet and everyone is offering this global MPS. We had to differentiate ourselves. And we said we are going to move a little bit further and see what other services we are going to start offering. And what we have done today is we have moved out of just offering internet, which I always call a highway. You know, anyone can have data and have that internet, but it's what you put on top of that internet. And what we have done as MTN, one of the things that we've done today, like I mentioned, we have got a new tier 3 data center that we just launched in March, which has got about 78 rack space. And the question one would ask themselves is, but then what do you want to do in this data center? Yes, co-location is one thing. If I'm traveling and I'm out of this phone and I've got network connectivity wherever I am, actually I can receive my phone calls from my extension on this number. So I do not need to be fixed in my office for you to phone me on my extension. And that saves a lot on people that are roaming. It will save you a lot of cost. At the same time, inter-branch. If you've got a branch in Kisumu, I don't have to dial the entire phone number, I just dial the extension and I'll be able to talk to my colleague in Kisumu, in Mombasa, free cost. No spend that is involved in there. And we are finding customers really wanting to use that service because one, they take advantage of the price that is involved. They are saving on the capex because they don't have to invest in the IPBX.
To give customers world-class services through the latest technologies in the industry, MTN Group has established partnerships with some of the world's best service providers who help them stay at the top of the game with the latest trends and innovations. One such partner is Microsoft. MTN Business has a strategic partnership with Microsoft to provide a Pan-African cloud platform that offers customers a true hybrid cloud solution serviced from MTN's data centers. It also boasts of partnerships with firms like Accenture in a bid to provide leading-edge platforms, products, and services to small and large companies across Africa and the Middle East.
For me, I've got a specific department that is called partnerships, because I do realize there are players in the same industry that could be doing things better than we are in certain areas, but there are certain things they may be lacking as well. And how do I help them to be able to work with us and be able to make the customer happy? So I'm not going to go in as MTN and say I'll do it on my own, but I'm going to go in and find other people that will be able to do it with successfully to the satisfaction of the customers. And we have invested in what I call the Microsoft Azure Pack. What that does, it is a data center service that helps a customer not to invest in CapEx. So they don't need to invest in capital expenditure. We are saying we'll give you the data center service out of MTN. All you need to do is bring your applications, run them from our platforms, and have it all. That saves you from buying the servers that you need to put in there. That saves you from having upgrades of the software that you are using. That saves you from having the resources to monitor, to upgrade, to refresh that equipment. MTN will take care of that. We shall give you the platform to do what you need to do. It's like giving you a key to your house. What you do in that house is really not a big deal for us. We've also gone a step further and said, we cannot win on our own in this market. It's super critical that we get partnerships. And we've partnered with the likes of Microsoft. The Azure platform is a Microsoft product. But we've gone and said, we also have people that want to have their data stored here in country. Hence, we give you this Azure platform. But on top of that, we are saying, what do you need to do if you want to run your Office 365 and you want to buy it locally from a trusted partner? We've moved on with Microsoft and we can sell you this Office 365 today, meaning your Outlook email, your Excel, your Word, your PowerPoint, you can buy it today from MTN.
The agility of these organizations enable MTN to provide a full cloud solution that embraces on-premise cloud solutions, hybrid cloud solutions, as well as public cloud solutions. MTN Business has also developed platforms that enable application developers as well as independent software vendors to create locally relevant applications.
Cloud services is one thing that MTN believes heavily as a solution to try and bridge this technology gap and trying to bring much cheaper technology to most people which people can afford. For instance, the Azure platform, that's a pure cloud environment where you do not need to have your equipment in your office. It is all cloud-based, stored in the cloud, but you are able to access it in real time wherever you are.
The center allows cloud computing, virtualization, and convergence. The Nairobi center becomes MTN's 48th data center. Thirdly, MTN's expansive footprint gives it the advantage of serving its customers without border constraints.
One, we are a pan-African organization, right? The fact that we've got footprint which runs from Africa going all the way to the Middle East, I think that gives us enough coverage to be able to save not only our pan-African customers, but the customers that spread across different geographies. We are able to do that. Our data center presence across our footprint also is another strength that we have, because many people today would want to have their data close to where they are, and MTN has this potential, has this muscle to be able to do this. The other element is people. The fact that we are present in 24 countries, it means we are not short of the expertise we need to serve our customers. Customer centricity is at the center of everything we do, and it comes from the tone from the top, from senior management at group, cascaded down to the opcos. Customer centricity is key. So for us to be able to give this customer centricity, it means we need to have the right people in the organization to be able to serve the customers at the right time, with the right products, with the right price parities that are required.
This also gives MTN a pool of expertise to serve its customers. MTN offers tailored and bespoke solutions that cater for the requirements of corporates, SMEs, multinationals and public sector customers across its footprint in Africa and the Middle East. Solutions available are categorized into network solutions, data center solutions, and cloud solutions. For SMEs, MTN provides solution in two models, the fixed model and small packages. One of the solutions tailored for SMEs is Easy Accounting, which facilitates computing processes.
Target customers range from the large enterprises, which we call the LEs. These are local big companies that we have across the country. But beyond that also, we do have our what we call multinationals, our MNCs, so your multinational companies. If we look at where Kenya is today, most of the companies that are operating across East Africa, they have headquarters in Kenya. So nothing stops us from serving a customer actually from Johannesburg to Juba. Nothing stops us from doing that because we have the capacity, we have the capabilities, we have the infrastructure to be able to do that. But at the same time, we do recognize that we are in a market that is predominantly a small and medium enterprise ready market. And we've also looked at how do we actually serve these small enterprises. There's one specific product, one of the main products we have on the SMEs that we have developed, and this is called MTN Easy Accounting. And one would ask, what is this product called MTN Easy Accounting? This product is specifically targeted for the small and medium enterprises. We all know how expensive it is to have an accountant. What this product does is you having an accountant to run your books. It's a cloud product. It will do your payroll. It to do your debtors, your creditors, who do you owe, who owes you, how much money have you pumped in, who are you invoicing, at a cost of 1,600 shillings per month, 1,600 per month. And you're on top of that, it's also giving you storage because it's in the cloud. So the small SMEs today struggle to kick up with their businesses because of keeping their books in order. You find they have got a small box in the corner where all the receipts go in, but it becomes very difficult to know who's owing them out there. Who do they need to invoice? How much do they have they put in the business? Are they able to track this? So we've given them this product where they are able to actually track on a daily basis. As long as they are connected to the internet, they'll be able to see their information. Their information is stored. They can lose the device they have. As soon as they find a new device and log, they'll still be able to retrieve this information. So that gives them a huge peace of mind. But at the same time, they don't need a chartered accountant to be able to do that for them.
Colocation, on the other hand, allows corporates to secure the equipment such as servers, storage systems, and connections in the state-of-the-art data center. Other services tailored for enterprises and public sector include cloud, managed networks, security as a service, unified communications, and enterprise mobility. What does it take to succeed in such a business?
I think people is at the center of everything. You know, you can have the best technology, you can have the best products, but if you do not have the right staff that are engaged, it becomes a challenge to run an organization. There's nothing I would have done and succeeded in my role if I didn't have a team that is supportive and is there with me 24/7, because we run a 24/7 organization. We do not sleep. Our company runs 24/7 because we have got customers that are in manufacturing, and any hour, any minute counts for them. So without people, this engine cannot tick. And hence for me, staff is priority number one.
MTN Group has 400 kilometers of fiber in several major towns of Kenya, Nairobi, Mombasa, Kisumu, and Eldoret, not forgetting the recently installed state-of-the-art data center in Nairobi. Mr. Chinganya also believes in grooming people as much as he advocates for partnerships.
For me, I've got a specific department that is called partnerships, because I do realize there are players in the same industry that could be doing things better than we are in certain areas, but there are certain things they may be lacking as well. And how do I help them to be able to work with us and be able to make the customer happy? So I'm not going to go in as MTN and say I'll do it on my own, but I'm going to go in and find other people that will be able to do it with successfully to the satisfaction of the customers.
He, however, says this is a market that is saturated, but with market intelligence, it is a highly productive area. Kenya is a viable market as it ranks highly as a broadband user.
So if I look at the Kenyan market, I think this is one market for me that is ready from a technology perspective. Especially in the SME market, probably the LE, which is the large enterprises, and the MNCs, we can leave those on one side. But if you look at the typical Kenyan market today, it's purely an SME-driven market. If I look at other markets, I've seen not very different: Cameroon, Cote d'Ivoire, South Africa, Nigeria. I would say Africa is an SME market, and we need to recognize that. What is more critical as a business is, yes, if I know it is an SME market, the big question is, what am I doing about it? How am I making or producing these services and products that could be tailored to these markets, to be able to service these markets? Because an SME is not a market I would go in and sell internet out like I would sell to a big corporate or a big bank. I should be able to bring the product or the service to this SME that is very much affordable. And as MTN, I think if I look at where we want to get to, this is one market that we have to strategically address. And there's a lot of things that we are doing as an organization to address this market. I was meeting all the heads of enterprise 2 weeks ago in South Africa, where we had our own strategy session as to what is it that we need to do to address this market. And in the next couple of weeks, we'll be putting together a paper that is going to address each and every market in the SME space where we have footprint. Kenya is kind of lacking in that we probably the highest broadband user on the continent. And that cannot be taken for granted that it will stay like that. The big question is, what is it that we are doing as we access this technology that is out there?
Mr. Chinganya believes that the future of the business lies in technology.
I think we still have a long way to go. Yes, we've come a long way, but I think we still have a very long way to go. If we are to bridge the technology divide for Africa, I think there's need to be honest with ourselves and say we've got a very long way to catch up with some of our colleagues. And I'll bring it back home in Kenya. I think Kenya is kind of lucky in that we probably the highest broadband user on the continent. And that cannot be taken for granted that it will stay like that. The big question is, what is it that we are doing as we access this technology that is out there? And when we say we've come a long way, yes, we've come a long way, but most of us are still very traditional people when it comes to technology, because we want to have everything saved on our machine. But what we forget is what happens when that machine goes, because it is on a hard drive that could disappear, that could be stolen, that could be spoiled. And for us to really move in the right direction, now I think there is need to start looking at the cloud services. But beyond that, I think it's critical that businesses start looking at technology and saying, this is where my information sits. And information is the lifeblood of every organization. So if I lose this information, it means I've lost my organization. So what do I need to do? Technologically, it means I need to start either replicating, I need to start backing up this information. It's of no use to back up your information, keep it in the same office where you are as tapes. Because what happens if you can't access that office? It means you can't work. So what we are saying is, in as much as we've come from very far, let's also embrace the new technology that is now fast approaching and happening in our space, meaning try and separate your core operations, where it's happening and where you are backing the information from. And MTN is playing in this space. And we are saying, yes, we are going to sell you this kind of a service, but the question we ask you is not a commercial question. Do you have backup of your information? And if you do not have backup of your information, have you considered having a backup with reasons why we think you should have this backup? The reason for that is we want you to be able to access this information in real time as and when you need it without any hindrance.
Cowboys ain't easy to love and they're harder to hold. They'd rather give you some than diamonds or gold.
Lone Star belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. If you don't understand him and he don't die young, he'll probably just ride away.
Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies